Okay, good morning everyone. So today we are going to continue to the next lesson, which is chapter 5, lesson 9, volume of a solid by plane slicing. Yeah, so you can open your book, page 242. Okay, now I'll read the paragraph from your book. In section 5.8, you set up definite integrals by slicing a region into narrow strips. Yeah. In this section, you will extend the technique to find volumes of solids that have curved boundaries. The idea is to slice the solid into thin flat slabs. Find the volume of a representative slab by multiplying its area by its thickness, and then add the volume and take the limit as the thickness approaches zero. Yeah. So basically, on the previous lesson, we learned about how to find the area that is bounded by a certain function with definite integral, and now we're gonna extend it into a volume. Yeah. So the objective of this lesson is, if you are given a solid whose cross-sectional area varies along its length, then you need to find the volume by slicing it into slabs and performing the appropriate calculus and show that your answer is reasonable. Okay, so let's start. As we know, the foundation for this lesson is you have to keep in your mind that the volume is equal to the area multiply by the length or the height or the thickness. So it's basically it's two dimensional unit multiplied by a dimensional unit, and this one dimensional unit in this case will be made very thin. Yeah, very thin. So then it will be dv. Last time we used dA, it will be dv equals to the area multiplied by d of the length. And we call it slab. If it's an area, we call it stripes, right? Rectangle. In volume, we call it slab. Okay, so let's go to the example. Example one. The region under the graph of y equals x power of 1 over 3 from x equals 0 to x equals 8 is rotated about the x-axis to form a solid. Write an integral for the volume of the solid and evaluate to find the volume. Assume that x and y are in centimeters. Show that your answer is reasonable. Okay, let me draw it. The function is y equals to x power of 1 over 3. Yeah? So from 1 until 8, let's say this is 8. I'll just make it shorter. Yeah. So like I said, if it's like this is a power function, right? So we try the endpoint to sketch it. So it's basically 2 comma 8. And then if you wanna add, this is 4, this is 2, this is 1. If you wanna add, this is 1 comma 1 to make it clearer. So your graph will be like this. Okay, so basically this is the region. This is the region. Okay, so the region under the graph of y equals x power of 1 over 3 from x equals 0 to x equals 8 is rotated. Now, this is maybe a new term for you. This is a new case. Rotated. So this area, this shaded area, this white shaded area, is rotated around, is rotated about the x-axis. Yeah. So if you have this shape and it's rotated to the x-axis, then it's kind of gonna be like this, right? I will try to draw it to you. And maybe I'll use different color. So it's gonna be like a cylinder, right? It's gonna be like a cylinder. So imagine if you have a piece of paper like this, a piece of paper like this, and then you rotate it to the x-axis like that. You rotate it to the x-axis. Yeah. Then it will definitely create a shape of a cylinder, kind of. And if we are rotating the white shaded area, then it's gonna be kind of like this. I will try to draw it. It's gonna be kind of like this. And this is a full one. This is a full. And look at it as a three-dimensional shape. Yeah, it's gonna be like a bullet, yeah? Like a bullet in your gun, if you have a gun. It's like a bullet. Can you imagine it? Yeah, I hope you can imagine that. Yeah. So the question is to find the volume of that bullet. The bullet is formed by the area in below the graph of y equals x power of 1 over 3 from x equals 0 to x equals 8 and rotated to the x-axis. Yeah. So how to do that? The first step is to, again, it's as always when we are talking about the application for area and volume, the point is always, the first thing that you need to do is always to create a sample rectangle. Yeah, a sample rectangle. Let's say this is the sample rectangle. Yeah, a sample rectangle. And of course, the sample rectangle will be rotate it to the x-axis. It will be rotated to the x-axis like this. Let's say it's like this, okay? Yeah? Can you imagine? Okay. Okay, now let's say that I have this pen. I have this pen. Okay, I have this pen. Well, I'll remove the photo background. Let's say that I have this pen. Okay, this pen like this, and it is rotated to the x-axis. Yeah, it is rotated to the x-axis. Now, what kind of shape do you think it will make? Then, of course, it will make a very thin cylinder, right? It's gonna make this really thin cylinder, like a coin. But it's even thinner than a coin. Yeah? Right? So, this is your DV. This will be your DV. So after you determine the, after you make the thin rectangle, and then you rotate it to the x-axis, about the x-axis, then if you do that, then eventually you will have a shape that is kind of like a coin. Yeah, and a coin is a very thin cylinder, right? So of course, then the DV, will be expressed as, because it's a cylinder, so the formula is P R square times height, right? P R square times height. Now, pi, not P. why is a concern, so we can let it be. And then what's the radius of this coin? What's the radius from here to here? Then the radius is basically the height of the rectangle, right? And the height of the rectangle is actually y square, because this is the point of x comma y. Okay, and then what's the height? The height is the thickness of your coin, the thickness of your shape of the slab, yeah. And in this case, it is actually dx, right? So it's dx like this, yeah. So now you get the dv in term of the equation that we have. Now, how do we find the volume? Of course, that's the definite integral. Integral is actually adding all the slabs, adding all the slabs here, that the thickness is a very small number from 0 until 8. That's integral, right? The concept of the hidden integral, it's addition, integrate from 0 until 8 of pi, this is volume, y square dx, yeah. So pi is a constant, integral from 0 until 8, y square, so y is equal to x 1 over 3, so y square is equal to x power of 2 over 3, yeah. Yeah, dx, yeah, and then this is easy, so it's equal to pi, 2 over 3 plus 1, 5 over 3, so 5 x power 5 over 3, yeah. So then integral if value from 0 until 8, and then the result is, if you substitute with 8, and then the 3 over 5 can go out as a constant, 3 over 5 pi, and then we have the x power 5 over 3, 8 power 5 over 3 is 32 minus 0. Yeah, so the result is equal to 96 over 5 pi. So this is the exact volume of the of your kind of bullet shape, solid. Okay, and in your calculation, I want you to keep the pi as a pi. Yeah? I mean, you don't need to calculate it become a decimal number. Just keep it as 96 over 5 pi. That's the answer that I accept. Okay, I hope you understand. Now I'm gonna give you the second example so you get more picture about the application of a volume when we are talking about integral. Okay, well, this is still the same, this is still pretty similar with the previous one. So example two on your book, page 243, the region in quadrant one bounded by the parabola y equals 4 minus x squared is rotated about the y-axis to form a solid paraboloid. Yeah, so paraboloid. So this actually, this bullet, this kind of like bullet shape is called paraboloid. Okay. Find the volume of a paraboloid if x and y are in inches. Show that your answer is reasonable. Okay. The equation is y equals 4 minus x squared. Yeah. And as I said, just sketch it. To sketch, you know, the vertex, which is the h is equal to negative b over 2a, whatever is 0. So the k is 4. Yeah. So the vertex is 0, 4. And then the y intercept is 4, and then the x-intercept is, you know, the x-intercept will be positive or negative 2. Okay, so if I draw, y-intercept is 4, x-intercept is 2, and then only in the first quadrant, so I will just draw the first quadrant, okay? So this is your parabola. Okay, and this is the area that you are gonna rotate later. Okay. Yeah, I hope you understand. And then it says that it is rotated to the y-axis in this time in the y-axis. So it is rotated to the y-axis. So if this is your region, it's rotated to this direction. It's rotated to this direction. It's rotated in this direction instead of like this. Okay. So it means that the rectangle that you create must be horizontal because you want to rotate it this way. You want to rotate it like this. Yeah. If you create your rectangle vertically, then the rotation will be like this. And we are not going through this yet. Right now, your rectangle must be parallel to the rotating axis. One more time, for this method, your rectangle must be parallel to the rotating axis. Yeah, so it's horizontal. Yeah, horizontal. And then of course I will try to create the paraboloid. So if this is the graph on the other side, then it will be kind of like that. If you see three dimensionally, it's like a cap, yeah. It's like a cap. Okay. So again, the principle is to determine the dv, which is again, if you rotate this, if you rotate this shape, if you rotate the rectangle, then it will form a very thin cylinder. Yeah, very thin cylinder. So I will try it. So it will be a very thin cylinder like this. And this is kind of your rectangle. It's rotated like that to that direction. So again, of course, the volume formula will be pi r square height. Yeah, and of course it's gonna be pi. In this case, the radius will be the x. Yeah, because this is x comma y. So the horizontal distance, right? Horizontal distance. We are talking about x. If the previous one. Vertical distance, we are talking about the y value. So x square and the height is a small part of y, dy. Yeah, it means that the dv is equal to pi x square dy. Okay, and of course to find the volume, we need to integrate it, x square dy. And because it is dy, so we need to look at the y value, which is not 0 until 2, yeah, be careful, it's not 0 until 2, but it's 0 until 4. Okay. And the x square is defined as 4 minus y, dy, from 0 until 4, right? And then if I evaluate this integral, it's gonna be 4y, minus half y square, divided from 0 until 4. Oops, I forget the pi. So, yeah. So it's equal to pi, substituted with 4 is 16, minus 8, minus 0, yeah? Minus 0. So the answer is 8 pi. The answer is 8 pi. Okay, so I hope you understand this lesson, and later on we're gonna discuss more about the application. But for today, this is it. Yeah. So I hope today you learn how to find a volume of a solid when it is made by a region on the two-dimensional axis rotated to a certain axis, whether it's x-axis or the y-axis. Okay, thank you. See you on the next meeting. Bye-bye.